Hello everyone, how is it going? In today's tutorial, we're going to create a sliced face effect with flower and gem inspired by Mac D. Lopez, A Poster a Day. Let's begin. Alright, let's create a new file. We're going to file, new, and I set to this size. This is for the social media portrait size. Just hit OK. And change this black color to this color. Some of the purple color, and change this white color to make some gradient here with gradient tool. Click this icon, or the shortcut is J. Then make sure you change it to this FG to BG. Then just drag it down like this. You can hold Ctrl Shift to make it straight, and open up our main images by going to File, Open, and I choose this. As you can see, it's already in selected. You can see my previous video, the double exposure. It's the same method when you make selection to advanced shape like hair and the trees. So you can check it out and just drag it to here. You can press Shift S to scale it down and hold Ctrl Shift while scaling to make it proportional scale. Press Enter. Now we're going to make the slice effect with Bezier tool. Press B, and I start from here. Click this, and here, just make some slice effect. When almost finished, hold Ctrl, then click, and press Enter. Make sure you choose the girl layer and make it become separate by going to select and choose float, and you see it will create a floating selection. Then click this create new layer. As you can see, the another part on this layer, so I'm just going to choose the move tool and move it down to here and rename the layer by double click and name it and this. Next, we're going to create the the cut stroke effect. So create new layer and name it cut stroke. With Bezier tool again, press B. On here, just follow this shape. Finish on this. Then while in like this, go to path and you can turn up this to see the right line and right click, stroke to path and make it by 10. Just hit stroke. Alright, it will create the stroke. Then click the move tool and you can hide again in the path and hide this. In the cut stroke layer, we want to create a darker effect by right click, alt path to selection, and change this color to, with dropper tool, some of the face color, and the other one to some of the face color on the dark. With gradient tool, change it to this and just drag it around this, then press enter. Deselect it by going to select and choose none. Clean the stroke a little with eraser tool. Click this on the cut stroke layer, just erase it. Create one more for the inside part, so create new layer and name it inside. Place it below the cut stroke and with Bezier tool again, press B. Make some selection like this. Hold Ctrl click when almost finished and press enter. Place the layer below the slice one and with gradient tool click this, then just drag it. And press enter. Don't forget to deselect by going to select and choose none. Time to bring the flower by going to file, openness layer and choose this. Just hit convert and scale it down. Press shift S, hold control shift while scaling and place it on here. Place this slice 2 below this slice 1. This and the cut stroke, you can try to move it down and place it below the slice 1. Alright. Add more by going to file, open this layer and move it to here, and you can scale it down by pressing Ctrl Shift around this and press Enter. Add more floor to here and make some nice placement. And you can change the color slightly. Sample this, go to color and hue and saturation. Make it down. And on here. Next, create some shadow to bring up the realistic. Create new layer and name it shadow 1. With brush tool, click this icon. You can reset the color. Reduce the hardness to 0 and just brush it. And create a shadow again. Name it shadow 2 for this area. Next, create a circle, create new layer, animate circle. The circle tool, you can choose this, or the shortcut is E. Hold Ctrl Shift while scaling to make it proportional scale. And change this black color to some of the yellow color around this. With gradient tool again, click this. Change it to this. Just drag it. Okay, then press Enter. Deselect it by pressing Ctrl Shift A. Next, we're going to add the transparency with layer mask. So, right click, add layer mask. Choose white full opacity, then hit add. Reset the color again, click this icon. With gradient tool selected, just drag it. And press Enter. Bring the circle up a little with move tool and place it on here. Add some text with text tool, press T and type. Change the font to and reduce the size to. Alright, you can make some kern by 2 and place it on here. You can bring up the ruler to make it precise, so just going to drag it down to here and this too and this to here, and for the bottom to here. And for the center part, going to place it on here and change this color to white. Add more text. I'm just going to duplicate this tend to text to change the size to 14. Press Shift R to rotate, and hold Control Shift while rotating to make it 15 degree increment. Okay, and place it on here. And another one. Hide the guides by going to View, and uncheck this Show Guide. All the shortcut is Shift Control T. Lovely. So now last thing, we're going to create the petals particle. I don't know, I just love doing that. So go to File, Open, and just this. You see it's in one PNG. We're going to create a separate with float. So with Bezier tool again, press B and sample select this. Hold Control, then click and press Enter. Go to Select and choose Float. Just click this create new layer, name it, select more with Bezier tool again, and hold Control then click. Make sure you choose on this layer. If you want to float, again go to select and choose float, and just click this create new layer, name it, do the same. And bring up these 5 petals to here, just one by one, and place it on the top. Right, and make some nice placement. You can scale it up by pressing Shift S around this, or Control Shift while scaling, and press Enter. And create some blur effect by going to Filter, Blur, and choose this Gaussian blur. And for this, place it on here. Shift S to scale it down and hold Control Shift while scaling. Press Enter. And you can add some another blur effect. Begin to filter, blur, and choose this linear motion blur to create some speed effect like this. And hit OK. And this, just place it on here. I hope you learned something new, how to create this sliced face effect and game. See MacDia Lopez works, I put in the link in description for you to continue exploring this poster style. I'm Zakay from Zakay Design, create something good today. Thanks for watching.